Hey everybody, it's Jang here with a look at the LEGO Alpha Team Navigator and ROV from the Deep Sea Mission sub-theme of Alpha Team. It's kind of a combination. So there's a main underwater vehicle, you know, a main submarine that you see right there. It's very clear, but there's another one that's kind of embedded into it that you can remove. The large canopy piece here on the main one has the exclusive Deep Sea Mission print for Alpha Team. And it's not fully closed up, so there's just a little bit of gap on the side there. You just have to imagine that's completely closed up. No real big deal. Has two arms, as is fairly typical, and this has a great range of motion because they actually hinge these ones on the sides. And then, of course, you can bring them in and out. And this one here has, just on the side of it, a little camera. So rather than holding a camera, they use the hole in the stud there to attach that. So you can still use this to grab things. That's good. I appreciate still having full use of two hands. The other hand has nothing in it or on it. These are nice bumper pieces that have been used in a number of different themes, and they just look good here. They look like parts of roll cages. A couple of lights on the sides. Of course, you have to have your thruster units with the spinnable propellers on the back, and a big old spoiler bit, which actually looks appropriate. You can also rotate these thrusters so you can make it look like, you know, you get just pure vertical thrust for going up and down. Some of your minifig accessories get stored back here with the air tank and part of the rebreather apparatus, and your dive fins back here. You can also use that set of binoculars if you would like, but that right there, the TV, that's actually a printed piece right there, Mission Deep Sea. All right, this all comes down, and that's the thing that's deployable, that's removable. This is the ROV part of the set, so this can be deployed, and then you can bring its lights up like this, and you can just follow along behind it because it has a couple of spots where you can grab on with the hands, or at least one hand, of your minifig. And I like this. It has the little reins piece. It's also used as a stretcher holder, but done in yellow here. Works out really, really nicely well to give it a little bit of kind of a roll cage kind of appearance. I like this little thing. Taking off the canopy that I showed you first, has a very simple little operator's compartment with just a couple of control levers. Makes perfect sense. This figure is a named character, Cam Attaway, who has a very interesting face, actually. Got just the standard mold of helmet, and then they put the snorkel piece on there with the trans light blue color. But no print on the back of this is to be seen. The print on the front looks pretty good for its age. I appreciate that it goes through the hips and into the legs, but just look at that face. She actually has green eyes. It's a pretty unique looking face, all told, I would say, mostly by virtue of the colors that were used there, with the really heavy red, bright red eyeshadow really stands out. Now, speaking of red, they actually do include one additional thing, one additional piece in this set. Before I put it on, take a look at how much light comes through there. It's actually translucent. It's a dark red piece, but it was actually made translucent. I don't think that was the intent, but that's how it came out. And if you just look at regular LEGO dark red pieces through the ages, as you know, through the time that they've made them, a number of different color variations show up. And for some folks making custom stuff, it's very annoying because you're not able to get a completely consistent color if you use a lot of dark red stuff together. Well, this is just one of the possibilities. One of the things that has changed with dark reds over time is just the amount of opacity. So how much light gets through or doesn't. And with these, with this particular hairpiece, it was pretty extreme. I don't think any other pieces have had that much light that could just get through them, but that really makes this whole figure really stand out, I think, amongst all figures that LEGO has done. It's got some really interesting stuff going on. Lastly, with the instruction sheet, looking on the back of it, they give you a couple of suggestions for things that you can do to change up the design of this thing. That's interesting there. It's actually capturing a ROV up above. Changes the overall arrangement of things around. This one makes more sense to me. Looks more like something that I personally would do. I just like how it's all together and adds detail. You know, really makes it nice and dense in there. But both of them are good, and they really highlight how, even though There were a number of fairly large pieces used throughout this entire series. There's still a lot of rebuildability. Let me know what you think about this Alpha Team Navigator and ROV set by leaving a comment on the video if you would like. Thanks for watching. Talk to you again soon.